My name is Sanchez, and right now, you're in tune to Chris Cut, the number one on the radio.
Just tell him say you have your man and everything. Alright. Show him buy you a drink and get a dance. He must think that you're looking for romance. He want your number, so give him six. Tell him figure buy the lotto because him have a better chance. Let him know not because you're here only. Does he really, really mean say you love me? And if he don't leave you alone, what you gonna do is turn your head and just walk away slowly.
Ladies and gentlemen, all the way. Yo, ladies and gentlemen, this is a historical moment in DJ Chris Cut's career. Imagine this London, UK. Before me tell you who's up on the phone, this man and me, we literally grew up together. We go to the same church. We chat all kind of nonsense. When him come to London, England, there's not a concert this brother perform. I am not present there. I am always there. Whether it's in London, Brixton, Birmingham, whether it's in Nottingham, you name it, I am always there. Ladies and gentlemen, let me feature to you on SLRradio.com, the one and only Sanchez D.
Bless for that. Bless for that.
Yo! Yo! Well, my brother.
Yeah, no respect, Chris. Every time I go, you know, so go easy, my brother. I take it cool, you know?
It's a joy to have the man for my program, brother. This is a long await moment for DJ Chris Cut, I tell you.
Bless you that.
So how is everything going on, Kevin?
Yeah, well, so far so good, you know. So far so good, just finish up album and get not only a deal, but, you know, also signed right now one thing, which is my biggest thing right now in my career right now, you know?
Okay.
Yeah, I'm now signed to New Millionaire.
Their
partner is with Universal.
Yo.
And
so that's all like a big thing.
Yeah, so we just go and take it cool, you know, go and enjoy it, take it in, you know.
Alright, before we elaborate on why we don't see you for such a long time performing in England and your fans are so frustrated, before we get to that, is it true we always aspire and a drive up and down? This is a part where me start ask the questions them now. But why you talk me through, start from Mango Rambo sound days with Flowagan and Red Jordan. Cause Flowagan tell me some things, and why you start from Mango Rambo sound system, then it come from Whitehall, where they are Constance Spring, Whitehall Avenue.
Yeah.
Oh, it starts with Kevin Jackson.
Yeah, man. With some more time, them come link me. After far, I know, say sometimes them come link me, I just don't put that on me, I'm close.
Yeah.
And we say, alright, that can buy some flour. And we don't have nothing more. And we say, alright, you rather don't know. Mass, Mass John used to have an attitude. I say, you don't know. But what kind of attitude today? No? Trust me, God, this will ever get the fish time.
Yeah.
The big time. So, that's how we used to live. We used to live like real people. You know?
Yeah.
Sometimes we're hungry and sometimes we have a thing where we can cook out some rice and peas and chicken, you know, everybody nice.
Yeah.
Long glass of lemonade and thing, you know. Real thing, man. When them things do happen just once in a blue moon, not to let the God shoot, because sometimes we go play a song and we come back. I hate dollar. We not tell him no lie. We stand up on the song whole night, $80. Sure, we not tell him no lie. Yeah, but you know, things get better as you grow. If you love it, you have to stick with it, you know. So you thick and thin, yeah, we have to do that. Bless you.
Kevin, we know, I know that the whole talent started from the church. How you discover this talent? How does this talent just emerged on the eye?
Well, I want to lose an inbound card, straight up inbound thing, guys. I've never been to any pharma institute, any pharma, no one ever really, you know, teach me anything about music. I've never been taught anything where music is concerned. It's just me used to, you know, go to the dance hall and watch them and try to do the same. And wow. I think that's the mechanism, so we just pick it up as a you know, as a career.
Yeah. So, while we were at church, as a lead choir boy, man, may I tell you, when you sing in a church, the whole place mash up it.
Yeah, man, I hear it, man. I hear it.
So, all right, the love for the dance hall and the sound system started at what tender age was this?
Well, I'm with us about 18, you know, 17, 18, you know, but you know, me at the church still, so nothing, you know, I was going to church team, so I couldn't do anything, because I got a slap in my head, but you know, my mom don't run.
I tell you, you know.
Right, so, you know, to keep focus and keep the thing jiggy, you know.
Exactly. Yeah, man.
But you know, until it go on until, you know, grew to be a man, and I know it wasn't the right thing, but you know, after loving the music so much and passing out some nice sound, and I hear them play and hear the bass, and you know, you hear the man on the mic and it sounds so cute. Yeah, mm-hmm. I say, yeah, you know, that one, you know, God, no, you know. So we just start to pursue a career, you know, and a lot of places I went to, man, and you know, man told me, try to see already, you know, me dad, so if I come up for the next 3 weeks or the next month, give yourself some time and go and practice. Yeah, I tell myself, so me now I'm gonna stop, keep going until somebody tell me about Red Man High Power used to play down a Gold Street. I say, yeah, you may buy the hook or the cook. I'm going at the bad man them territory. For real, because somebody have to know about this talent. I'm actually the first night we sing, man. Believe me, man. The man tell me, you know, my voice, so come link me tomorrow, I'm going to rescue the boom, boom, boom. And from there, so, you know, we touch the tune there.
We sang with this?
Lady Red, man.
Oh, what? Big number one still in the UK, same way.
Yeah, man, it never really got number one still, but it got way up on the chart. It went about like 16, I think, on the charts.
Yeah.
To be honest. Yeah.
See?
Yeah, man. But my first number one still was Loneliness.
Now that took the place by star, and you record that for Mr. Riley, Techniques Record, right?
Yeah, definitely.
Okay.
Definitely.
Let me just remind our listeners who we have on the phone. Ladies, we have the girls them pet, them call it. Why them out and name them gay, you know, Sanchez? We're talking to Sanchez D. The great Sanchez, man. Lonely won't leave. Yeah, I just see him, Sanchez. Yeah, we're talking to Sanchez right here in SLR. Right here in SLR.com. So the first song you recorded was Lady in Red. Then your first number one was Lonely Won't Leave. Yo, Kevin, tell me something. Your first time in a recording studio, was it nerve-wracking?
What? I mean, if you tell you, man, and I was wondering, if I'm gonna do well.
Yeah.
That was my first concern, you know, if I'm gonna do well and, you know, thing if I'm gonna like, we're not gonna do anything.
Yeah.
But you see, from I put that headphone on my ears.
Yeah.
Everything that I used to practice in the dance hall come right back, and I just handled it like the dance hall. So it just worked out good, man. Work out all right.
Okay. So how did Miss Ivy gravitate to this thing? How your mom gravitate to you doing both church, both dance hall?
Yeah, well, I actually started doing the dance hall thing or the music thing when, you know, I wasn't going to church no more. Because my mother said to me, yeah, because she definitely drew me up on the nose, so I'm at me know, you know? It's either snake or spider. Yeah, man, she said to me, "Is either you go and go to church and do the right thing, or no matter the church, because we're not going to have you going down Saturday night and coming to church to sit on the choir Sunday. Mm-hmm. So tell you the truth, you know, and I can have a gift to myself. Some just say, yeah, you may. Let me just focus on one thing.
Yeah.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, but right now my heart is not, still is not hardened, and my neck is not stiffened.
Yeah.
We don't know what is what. We know the Father. We know what, you know, what is capable. So anytime him call, man, I'm at his beckon.
Okay. Now.
Yeah, man.
So from Rambo Mango Sound to the big sound, yeah, the sound slipped my mind. The sound of White, sound of name again, man. anyway, it's too forward to me. So recording studio was nerve wracking, and you know, you probably take about 1,000 take. I just take one take.
Ah, good question. Yeah, sometimes I take a one take. You know, so I was so wicked then, man, and I practice all my songs. Cause them songs I used to sing,
yeah,
and record. Mm. These songs that I used to sing to girls at school. So it's something that I practice and know well. So yeah, it was elementary, man. Trust me.
Yeah. No. Your first time ever on a stage show, a proper stage show. Now, wonder what going inside of your head then, or that me, I wonder, you know?
All right. I know, so the first proper stage show I ever went up on in my school, can you imagine that? We tear it down! All right. Believe me, man. It was Derek Barnett. I'll never forget it. That's the first time I'm meeting that band named Sagittarius.
Yeah.
I mean, I say, and them get all everybody who's gonna sing a song to rehearse with the band, and believe you me, man. And from there, some man there look at me and say, yo, you're wicked in my heart. Why you not first watching that music type thing? And they say, all right. Yeah, and from there, some man from school, man, they had a concert in school, at school. I mean, I tell you,
which school is it?
Man. And the song I'm using and play, them, that song I'm say, on a cold and gray Chicago man, another little baby child was born in the ghetto. I'm done it.
So, which school was this?
Eh?
Which school was this?
Yeah, man. What a secondary, man.
Ah, for secondary. Hey, Kevin. Yeah, you know what I say? I go up a secondary a night called Jamaica night for go sing. And a lot of people don't know so I sing it, them things about us DJ. You know. I'm go up a secondary the night, you know. Me and Ghost and Culture and Beaky Bailey and Doug's Ranks. And when the man them call me up on stage, you know, so me jump up on stage, you now and hold the microphone now for sing my little piece now. You know, so I have to forget to me go sing, say. Why me just drop the mic and say, why the vibes are right? A 6 month, nobody no see me if I'm locked up in my head. I practice, you know.
yeah, but that's where you went wrong. That's not a little bad truth. Believe me, it happens to the best of us. You know how much time I go up on stage and still trying to do my show and thing, but it's, you know, it's always good. That's why it's always good to have band members.
Yeah.
You know, you can turn and say something, man, somebody will say, oh, that can really sing a little part, and you remember it right away. A lot of time it reached me.
Mm-hmm.
I ain't gonna lie. Yeah. A lot of times it meets no man, but it can happen to the best of us. Because sometimes, I mean, the slip of the tongue is not always a fault than mine, and I'm not telling the truth.
Okay.
Yeah, sometimes your tongue just slip. I say something.
Yeah. All right. SLRradio.com Sound System Fridays with DJ Chris Scott. We're on the phone line here. We're talking to the legendary Sanchez, veteran, icon. That man here. The girls them scream when the man here sing. I'll feel. Cause on a pinch us alone, the girls them feel for the girl them feel for Sanchez as well. Now,
so
we're talking about the recording studio. So we leave from this, so now. And you talk about your very first stage show. And we leave from this, so now. We're going to talk about the influence, who influenced you, who are the musical icons that inspired you to pursue this career right up until now.
Yeah, well, naturally, you know. Dennis Brown was the first man, and people like Bob Marley, which all of us know, you know, the world know Bob Marley, give thanks, and may his soul rest in peace. Yeah, and I'm next look at you, Jonah Tucker. You see that image, that tender image when you were singing them song. We son of the kind, do you choose? Now them song, man, I swear to God, man, I was grudging you. Believe me, I have a lot. Yo, I was grudging the youth. I mean, I said, yeah, no, the little youth, they can't sing. I mean, so what? I can't seem to see me come my voice almost in. Somebody say, you know, man, I'm going to do it, man. I'm going to put my foot forward and I'm going to do this. And believe you me, man, we even started racing in the same building one at a time at the same beach. Yeah, so, you know, we have to just pursue whatever, man, whatever we have, and we see that, you know, we dream of, just pursue it, man. Just put our foot forward and just go relentless. You know?
Yeah, man. All right, but do some of the name of the song now. Crystal Disco, Whitehall Avenue, over there.
Yeah, man, that's my favorite song, man. That's my favorite. No, bonafide. You know, so the owner for my song used to vex with me more time. Because when more time, you don't know, it's a small world, and Jamaica small, and my local town small. So every time I go link Crystal in here. You know? So, he used to carry a little grudge. But me did love Crystal, because a man that take pride in him sound and whatever him play. So me did really love that, trust me.
Yeah, man, Crystal is going to lock down Whitehall Avenue, man. Even over site, that's before even site build up.
Nice sound, very nice sound. Very nice selector, everything. Love them selection. Them want to remind me of Stone Love. Young Stone Love.
Yeah, man. Now, how did the Dynamic Duels form? Flower Gun, Red Dragon, Daddy Lizard, Sanchez. How did the group form?
Well, we just growing up in the same area, you know, Chris. Growing up in the same area, and we found out that, you know, we had the same dream.
Yeah.
Yeah, man, we just said, alright, okay. So we just started doing it together, and, you know, They don't start wheels and sounds and until we just get serious. We just got serious about the thing until it's really sad right now, to be honest.
Well, I remember one memorable moment in an item performance, a reggae Sunsplash 1986. Why may I tell you? Why may I tell you, man? What a wicked performance, man. The four mash up the whole place. And we have to talk about also Sting as well. Come back right to the great days of the great stage shows, man. Afloat Clarence Beach, man, and, you know, Champions in Action and Fresh, and they were going back to Skateland. And boy, may I tell you, how would you say your musical career from the early 80s right up until 2000? How would you sum it up?
Well, I do what I know is best. I make sure I'm not going to do anything that's going to hurt me, you know, in the long run. And I try every time I try to record a song.
Yeah.
I always think highly of my fans. More so the elder folks, because we know them love Sanchez and them listen Sanchez. So, you know, it just would be a big disappointment, you know, to hear Sanchez saying certain things.
Yeah.
Not a little bad, but so I try to keep it clean. And then I think maybe that's what, you know, has kept my career over the years.
And I always
remembering the father, because a lot of us, you know, the music business, we feel like a real thunder, and because a little thing going on for us, and we have songs playing on the radio, and people screaming for us that we are gods.
Yeah.
And I want to make the people then know straight up, say, right now, I'm no God. I'm just somebody that's been blessed, and I'm just using that blessing, you know, to how I feel best, and people love it.
Yeah.
And I'm just glad, and I'm going to do it because it's something good.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Straight.